إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يروي إمام البخاري رحمه الله عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه وعن البراء بن عازب رضي الله عنه يقول براء كاد الخياران أن يهلكا أبو بكر وعمر He says البراء The two best ones They were about to be destroyed. They were about to fall into a loss. Abu Bakr and Umar. لما جاء وفد بني تميم. When the people, the emissaries from Banu Tamim, the tribe of Tamim, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to accept Islam. فقال أبو بكر, Abu Bakr said, أمر عليهم القعقاع بن معبد. He said, O Messenger of Allah, make their leader Al-Qaqa ibn Ma'bad. وقال عمر, and عمر, he said, رضي الله عنه, بل أمر عليهم الأقرع ابن حابس. But rather, O Messenger of Allah, you should make the leader الأقرع ابن حابس. أخي بني مجاشع. فقال أبو بكر, أبو بكر, he said then, ما أردت إلا خلافي. You only said that, Umar, because you want to oppose me. فَرَدَّ عُمَرْ Umar, he replied, saying, وَاللَّهِ مَا أَرَدْتُ خِلَافَكَ I did not say that just to oppose you. Is that I think that أقرع should be the leader. فَتَمَارَيَا And they started to argue. حَتَّى عَلَتْ أَصْوَاتُهُمَا To the point their voices were very high in front of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَأَنزَلَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he revealed the verses. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أو يهو بليف لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله do not precede Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم to the end of the first ayah and the second ayah of Surah Al-Hujurat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says يا أيها الذين آمنوا أو يهو بليف لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي do not raise your voices over the voice of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم Do not speak with a loud voice in front of him. And تَحْبَطُ أَعْمَالُكُمْ Because that's a great sin. Allah will destroy all of your good deeds. Your salah, your zakah, your siyam. Allah will destroy it all. وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ The verse was revealed right then. Abdullah ibn Zubair. And he is the rawi of this hadith. He said, فَكَانَ عُمَرْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ عُمَرْ إذا كلم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يسمعه حتى يستفهمه. After that, when Umar رضي الله عنه would speak to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet would have to ask him, "What did you say, Umar?" Because his voice was that low. Umar, Umar رضي الله عنه. When you mention Umar, all of us know the strength. البطل المغوار, the great warrior, سيف من سيوف الله الفاروق. The one who the shaitan runs away from him, Umar. That is how much the Quran, ya ikhwani, had the effect on them. This is called al-istislam. Our deen is Islam. Al-islam huwa al-istislam lillah, al-inqiyad lillah. The meaning of Islam is to submit to Allah. This is how they submitted to Allah. the verse comes down, لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ, do not raise your voices. From that moment, Umar radiallahu anhu, when he used to speak to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have to say to him, Umar, what did you say? I don't hear you. Because that's how low his voice was. And Abu Bakr, he said, Wallahi, Ya Rasulallah, from today, I will only speak to you like how two people speak about a secret. Al-Istislam. The Quran comes down. That is how quick and how ready they are to submit. And that is how the believers should be. And that is what we are missing today. أن يكون شعارنا سمعنا وطعنا. That our slogan should be, we hear and we obey. On the other side of the city, after a few days, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم افتقد ثابت ابن قيس ابن الشماس رضي الله عنه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he noticed he has not seen the great Sahabi who's called Thabit ibn Qais ibn Shammas. He noticed he has not seen him for a few days after this verse was revealed. Thabit was not there. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that's how the Muslim should be. He noticed Thabit has not come to the masjid for a few days. And so he asked his neighbors, Ashtaka Thabit, is Thabit sick maybe? And they said, Ya Rasulullah, نَأَتِيكَ بِأَخْبَارُ, we'll come with his news, we'll go and ask. When they went to the house of Thabit ibn Qais ibn Shammas, فَوَجَدُوهُ بَاكِيًا, they found him sitting there crying. And he had told his wife, lock the door for me, I'll never go outside. فَإِنِّي مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ, because I am from the people of the hellfire, because my deeds have been destroyed, because أَنْتُمْ تَعَلَمُونَ, you know, أني رجل سيئت أرفع صوتي عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I am someone with a loud voice, and he used to be someone with a loud voice. He was the one who was the khatib of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was the spokesperson of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was a very good speaker, and he had a loud voice. This verse is revealed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the masjid or wherever. He is at home. He hears. There's a new verse which has been revealed. Do not raise your voices over the voice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam right away. Why? Because your actions will be rendered invalid. He says, this is me. My actions have been destroyed. Ana rajulun min ahli an-nar, I'm going to the hellfire. That is how much the Quran affected them. They knew that every verse in this book, they knew that every hadith the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says or he does, it is for all of us to follow. That is what is called Islam. And that is why we are Muslims. Otherwise, we are not Muslims. So they returned with the news to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they said, this is what Thabit said. He said, this verse was revealed. And all of us, we know that he is the one with the loudest voice. So his deeds are rendered invalid. And he is going to the hellfire. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, لا بل أبشر بل بشروه بالجنة فإنه رجل من رجال الجنة. No, he's not from the people of the hellfire. Rather go and give him the good news that he is one of the men of Jannah, paradise. Anas رضي الله عنه, he says, كنا نراه يمشي ونعرف أنه رجل من رجال الجنة. We used to see him walking on this earth, and we know this is a man of Jannah already. That is how much they submitted. Now everybody should ask himself, how much are you submitting to Allah? How much are we submitting to Allah? And I say again, that is what we are missing today, Muslims. وَأُخْرَى, and another story. Al-Bara ibn Azib, radiallahu anhu, the previous hadith was from Abdullah ibn Zubayr. In Sahih al-Bukhari also, he says, صلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قبل بيت المقدس 16 شهرا أو 17 شهرا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he prayed, the prayer we pray, facing بيت المقدس in Jerusalem, and we ask Allah to return it to the Muslims soon. 16 or 17 months, He prayed facing Al-Aqsa. وَكَانَ يُعْجِبُهُ أَن تَكُونَ قِبْلَتُهُ قِبْلَ الْبَيْتِ. But he, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to love and to wish that the Qibla will be turned to Mecca. حَتَّى أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى until Allah revealed the verse, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً الَّتِي تَرْضَاهَا. We have seen how you always turn to the skies, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, turning to Allah, asking Allah, please change the Qibla to Mecca. And Allah says, now you can face Mecca. فَكَانَ أَوَّلُ صَلَاةٍ صَلَّاهَا صَلَاةُ الْعَصْرِ. And the first prayer he prayed facing Mecca was Salatul Asr. فَخَرَجَ رَجْلٌ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ الَّذِينَ صَلَّ مَعَهُ. One of the men who prayed with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the new Qibla, he left the masjid. فَمَرَّ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْمَسْجِدِ. He passed by another masjid in Medina, وَهُمْ يُسَلُّونَ. And they are praying facing Al-Aqsa. فَقَالَ لَهُمْ. And he said, while they are praying, وَكَانُوا رَاكِعُونَ. And they were in the state of ruku'. They were in bowing. فَقَالَ لَهُمْ أَشْهَدُ بِاللَّهِ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَدْ تَوَجَّهِ إِلَى الْكَعْبَةِ. I bear witness by Allah that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has turned the Qibla and is facing the Kaaba in Mecca. فَدَارُوا كَمَا هُمْ. And those Sahaba were praying. They turned in the same state. They were in ruku'. They turn from this direction and they face that direction. That is Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has done that. That is what we need to know. No questions, no ifs, no buts, no whens. Allah has revealed the Quran, that's it. They did not say, let's finish this prayer and then discuss. Let's see what our madhab says. Let's see what our masjid does. The things which are bringing us down, Muslims. Dividing us. We need to submit to Allah. We need to be Muslims to Allah. Ibn Umar says, also in the Sahihain, in Bukhari and Muslim, فَأَمَّا أَهْلُ قُبَاءٍ. As for the people of Quba, فَمَا وَصَلَهُمُ الْخَبَرْ إِلَّا السُّبْحَ فِي يَوْمِ الثَّانِ. The news did not reach them. Quba today we see it is close to Medina, but back then it's not that close. They did not get the news until the Fajr, which was coming. فَمَرَّ بِهِمْ الرَّجُلُ. One man of the Muslims, he passed by them while they were praying. فَقَالَ لَهُمْ. And he said to them, إِنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَدْ أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ اللَّيْلَةَ قُرْآنَ وَقَدْ تَوَجَّهَ إِلَى الْكَعْبَةِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yesterday, there is new wahi which has come to him, revelation, and he has turned to face the Kaaba. فَدَارُوا كَمَا هُمْ. While they were in the prayer, they also turned just like they were in the prayer. From this direction, they faced that direction. They did not ask why, how, when. This is Islam, ikhwan. This is Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ دِينًا مِمَّنْ أَسْلَمُ وَجَهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. And no one is better in the religion. No one has a better religion than the one who submits himself to Allah. And then he is a good person himself. There's nothing better than that. Submit yourself to Allah. كَمَا أَنْتَ عَبْدٌ لِلَّهِ اِضْطِرَارًا فَكُنْ عَبْدًا لِلَّهِ اِخْتِيَارًا. Just like all of us are servants of Allah, whether we want it or not, we are servants of Allah. So let's make a choice also and be servants of Allah by choice and say, we submit to you. وأخرى, another one. Also in Sahih al-Bukhari, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. Or in the Musnad of Ahmad, in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad, the authentic hadith. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he narrates from Anas radiallahu anhu, says, and as we know, khamr, alcohol, was something which was a custom within the Arabs. They used to drink it morning, evening, night. And the prohibition of alcohol came gradually. It came gradually. Why? Aisha radiallahu anha, she says, if the first things the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was brought with, if the first message he came with was don't drink, don't commit zina, nobody would have believed. Because these are people have been doing that for hundreds of years. But 13 years in Makkah, 13 years in Makkah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was no fasting, there's no zakah, there's no hajj. And even salah was just a few months before he went to Medina. What was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaching, ikhwani? What was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaching? Al-Islam. Submitting to Allah. He was preparing the hearts so that tomorrow, when the verse comes and says, pray five times, they're ready. When tomorrow the verse comes and says, give of your wealth, they're ready. When tomorrow the verse comes and says, face this direction, they're ready. No questions. When tomorrow the verse comes and says, now alcohol is haram, they're ready. And that is the way to Islah. And that is why our da'wah, da'wah to Salafiyah, da'wah to Islah, it is the only way Muslims can return back to that majesty up there which you are missing. We have to rectify our hearts first. Lakin wallahi, even if you told the Muslims, 99% of them, and maybe I'm wrong, and you told them today we start to practice the Sharia, the Muslims are the one who are going to revolt against you and say, we don't want that, because the hearts are not ready. The point is, ikhwani, Anas, he says, and this was before khamr was completely haram. Kuntu asqi Aba Ubaid ibn al-Jarrah wa Ubay ibn Ka'b wa Suhail ibn Bayda wa ashabuhu. I was the one, because Anas was a young man, fi bayt Abi Talha, in the house of his stepfather Abu Talha. I was the one who was pouring the wine for them. Hatta kada al-khamr an ya'khudha bi عقولهم أو برؤوسهم حتى مالت رؤوسهم until they were about to get drunk. فنادى مناد, and we heard someone calling out. Listen very carefully. فنادى مناد, someone called out from outside. ألا إن الخمر قد حرمت. Surely alcohol has been made haram. اسمع. قال أنس رضي الله عنه. Listen what Anas said. فَمَا قَالُوا حَتَّى نَسْأَلْ وَنَنْظُرُ. They did not say, until we ask, until we see what we're going to do. Anas, he says, فَمَا قَالُوا, they never said, those great Sahaba, حَتَّى نَنْظُرُ وَنَسْأَلْ. They are drinking, and they hear someone calling out. They don't even know who it is. They did not say, until we see what is happening, let us ask. For Allah, قال, they said right away, Ya Anas, أكفي الخمر, spill it all out. وأكسر القلال, and break all the containers and the glasses of alcohol. فمنهم من توضع, some of them they made wudu, ومنهم من اغتسل, some of them made غسل, وأصابوا من طيب أم سليم, and they took the perfume of أم سليم in the house which they were. وراحوا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they went to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهو يتلو, and he's reading, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, أو you who believe, إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون. It is from the work of shaitan. Stay away from alcohol. And all of you know the story. The streets of Medina were filled with alcohol. Everybody right away. And you have to know, alcohol was a commodity, just like oil is a commodity today. People used to deal with alcohol. People used to keep alcohol to sell. There was a lot of money. Everybody spilled it out until the streets of Medina was filled with alcohol. Islam! That is how they submitted to Allah. They did not say, let us ask, let us see. This is Islam, ikhwani. This is Islam. Wa ukhra, another one. Another one. Ma'qil ibn Yasar radiyallahu anhu, he says, kuntu tazawajtu o zawajtu ukhti li ahad min al-muslimina fi ahd nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I married my sister to one of the sahaba during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fakanat ma'ahu ma kanat, she stayed with him whatever time they stayed. ثم طلقها, then he gave her a divorce. ولم يراجعها حتى انقضت العدة, and he never took her back until the عدة, the waiting period, it finished. He never took her back. When the iddah finishes, now she becomes a strange human, ajnabiya. You cannot just take her back. You have to do a new nikah with a new dowry and all the conditions. فَخَطَبَهَا مَعَ الْخُطَّابِ So he proposed again amongst other people who proposed to my sister. فَقُلْتُ And I said, وَاللَّهِ لَا نُزَوِّجُكَهَا I will never get her married to you again. زَوَّجْتُكَهَا وَأَكْرَمْتُكَ I married her to you and I made you noble. I gave you my sister and then you left her. ولكن هي هويته وهويها but she desired him and he still loved his wife وشاء الله أن يكون معا and Allah he willed that they have to be together and she said I will not marry anyone except him but معقل he's a brother an older brother just like all of us if someone was to marry your sister and then divorce her maybe without any reason الله أعلم You have that ghira, that pride you have as a human being. And Ma'qil, this is what he said. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals the verses. Allah reveals the verse in Surah Al-Baqarah. فَلَا تَعْذُلُوهُنَّ أَنْ يَنْكِحْنَ أَزْوَاجَهُنَّ إِذَا تَرَاضَوْا بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ When the woman is divorced, and the husband, the ex-husband comes back, and he still wants her, and she still wants him, You, the wali, you have no way to stop her. Ma'qil, when he heard the verse, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reciting. He said, "Sam'an li Rabbi wa ta'a." I hear my Lord and I obey. I'm going to get you married. Islam, the verse comes down. There's no questions. Today, us Muslims, ask ourselves, Ikhwan. Let's ask ourselves. When someone tells you, this is what the Quran says. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught. Are we like this? Islam, submission. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم البر الكريم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه الحمد لله كما يليق بجلاله وعظمة سلطانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت باركت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد الله سبحانه وتعالى سيزي إخواني وما كان لمؤمن ولا مؤمنة إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم. It is not for the believer, male or female believer, that when Allah has decided a matter, brought it in the Quran, that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam decided a matter, brought it in the Sunnah, it is not for the male or the female believer to go against that or to have any other option. You don't have an option if you're a real Muslim. And that is why it's called the beautiful religion of Islam, submission. If you believe Islam is the truth, and it is the truth with no doubt, then you have to believe also that everything Islam brought is the truth and is good for us. Whether we understand or we don't understand. If you don't understand something from the rulings of Islam, it is our minds which are limited. It is our minds are limited, but Islam is one package. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ Are you going to believe in some and leave some? فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا Those of you who do that, they take some parts of Islam and they leave some parts. What will you have? خِزْيٌ, humiliation. You'll be disgraced in this life. Will be lowly. People will be stepping on us every day. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ And on the day of resurrection, you'll be returned to a heavy and painful punishment. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا All you who believe, أُدْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ كَافَّةً Enter into submission completely. give yourself to Allah and say, Ya Rab, I believe in you. And you never oppress anyone. You are the most gentle one, Al-Latif. You are the most generous one, Al-Kareem. You are the one who loves most, Al-Wadud. You are the most merciful one, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Don't you want to submit to a God who's like that? Submit. That is what we are missing. قوموا للصلاة.